अपनी मौवा मोहित्रा।
Thank you, Honorable Speaker Sir, my esteemed colleagues in the 18th Lok Sabha. I stand here on behalf of my party, Pradhan Mr. Prime Minister, Honorable Prime Minister. I would really request you, since you've been here for the better half of 1 hour, ये भी सुनते हुए जाइए सर, डरिए मत सर, डरिए मत। दो बार आ गए सर, you came to my area twice during the campaign, सर आज तो सुनके जाइए सर। Never mind, my bad luck. Honorable Speaker Sir, Rahul. Sir, Honorable Speaker Sir, my esteemed colleagues in this newly constituted 18th Lok Sabha. I stand here on behalf of my party, the All India Trinamool Congress. कोई बात नहीं, वो मेरे LOP है, वो मेरे LOP है, वो already मुझे सुन चुके हैं, वो मेरे LOP है. Honorable Chair, Honorable Speaker Sir, my esteemed colleagues, in this 18th Lok Sabha, I stand here on behalf of my party, the All India Trinamool Congress, to speak on the Honorable President's address. The last time I stood here, sir, the last time I stood here, I was not allowed to speak. I was not allowed to speak. आप लोगों ने अरे लेट मी फिनिश आई डिंपल डिंपल लेट मी फिनिश गाइस
इग्नोर
लेट मी फिनिश हां जितना जिसको जाना है प्लीज जाइए नो प्रॉब्लम द लास्ट टाइम आई स्टूड हियर आई वाज नॉट अलाउड टू स्पीक बट द रूलिंग पार्टी हैज पेड अ वेरी हैवी प्राइस फॉर थ्रॉटलिंग द वॉइस ऑफ वन एमपी मुझे बैठाने का चक्कर में जनता ने आपके 63 सदस्यों 63 जन को परमानेंटली बैठा दिया यू हैव गॉन डाउन फ्रॉम 303 टू 240 इन माय मेडन स्पीच इन द लोकसभा इन जून 2019 आई स्पोक ऑन द 7 साइंस ऑफ फैशिज्म दैट वर टेकिंग ओवर दिस कंट्री 5 years to the date on June 27, 2024, this house saw the unprecedented scene of the marshals welcoming the President of India, the Honorable President, with the Sengol in their hand. The Sengol is a symbol of the supreme authority of a monarch. It has no place in the temple of a constitutional democracy. But Honorable Speaker, sir, it is understandable why this happened. Because the BJP has still not understood that their 303 brute majority, their Raj Tantra, has been reduced to a 240 seat minority by the Lok Tantra. They are still living in the world of the Sengol. This sudden change reality, this new reality, is yet to sink in for the treasury benches and especially for the speech writers of the Honorable President's address. The speech that the Honorable President read out, she said, the people of India have elected a stable government with a clear majority. Please do not embarrass the office of the President by using poorly edited cut and paste versions of old speeches. This is not a stable government. It depends on multiple allies with a history of U-turns. It has not got a simple majority. The BJP is 32 short of 272. It is going to be a very hard landing for the treasury benches, as was obvious today. This time there are 234 warriors this time, firmly united, and we have walked through fire to walk through these doors, so you will not be able to shut us up this time the way you did last time. There are numerous statements in the Honorable President's address that defy even a tenuous link to truth and to reality. Like in my 2019 maiden speech when I spoke in 7 signs, today I have picked out 6 themes from the Honorable President's address and I will analyze how each of them is an exercise in fallacy and exercise in untruth. The address covers many issues, but I have chosen 6 themes. The first theme, the Northeast. The Honorable President's address says that the government has increased allocation for the Northeast by 4 times, has worked for increased and lasting peace in the area. Now, I have one question. Why is the word Manipur nowhere in the speech? Why do we refer to the generic Northeast? During the Lok Sabha campaign, the BJP, the ruling party, the Honorable Prime Minister mentioned many words beginning with the letter M. Musalman, Mullah, Madrasa, Mughal, Mutton, Machli, Mujra, Mangal Sutra, but not once did they mention Manipur. We don't need to act east. The government says we want to act east. We don't need you to act east. Look east, walk east, and most important, embrace east. I stand here for my brothers and sisters of Manipur, and I quote the revolutionary poet Pablo Neruda. One morning the bonfires leapt out of the earth. One morning the bonfires leapt out of the earth, devouring human beings. And from then on the fire, from then on blood. Come, see the blood on the streets. Come, see the blood in the streets. Please go to Manipur, see the blood in the streets.
हमसे जुड़े रहने के लिए हमारे YouTube चैनल को सब्सक्राइब करें और नई वीडियो की नोटिफिकेशन के लिए बेल आइकॉन को दबाएं।